சுரகுரும் வந்தே ஜகத்காரணம் வந்தே பன்னகபூஷணம் சசிதரம் வந்தே வசூனாம் பதிம் வந்தே சூரிய சசாங்க வன்னிநயனம் வந்தே முகுந்த பிரியம் வந்தே பக்தஜன ஆஸ்ரயஞ்ச வரதம் வந்தே பக்தஜன ஆஸ்ரயஞ்ச வரதம் வந்தே சிவம் சங்கரம். ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், யோகா இஸ் இவல்யூஷன். இவல்யூஷன் மீன்ஸ் பரிணாமம். தி சீட் when it is sown, it sprouts. First there is a plant. The plant grows to be a huge tree. That tree was in the plant. Plant was in the seed. Plant did not come from outside. Tree did not come from outside. The tree and the plant came out of that small seed. When that seed unfolds, when that seed grows, it is called evolution. Small baby becomes a boy, a young man, an old man, a wise man. That wise man was in the man was in the boy was in the baby was in the womb. It is called evolution. Yoga, yogi is an evolved person. From what state he evolves or she evolves. From the seed to the tree, from the baby to the old man. Similarly, from inertia to awareness, yogi evolves. Inertia means lethargy. Inertia means laziness. Inertia means lassitude. Inertia means tamasika prakruti. I don't want to do anything. Inertia can be seen in sleep. Awareness can be seen in samadhi. From sleep to samadhi, evolution. From tamas to transcendental state beyond the trigunas. Tamasic prakriti, rajasic prakriti, sattvika prakriti, and beyond that, gunadida, trigunadida, and that is evolution. We have come here to Prashanti not to sleep, not to be lazy, not to be dull, not to be despondent, not to be in depression. Depression is a type of laziness. Bhagavad Gita commences with Arjuna's depression. Bhagavad Gita starts with Arjuna's despondency, his escapist tendency, his inertia, his laziness not to fight. A lazy man does not want to do anything. He wants to run away from all responsibilities, run away to play, to the room to sleep. So sleep or lethargy. From this state to that awareness state or consciousness, yogi evolves. This body is microcosm. The entire universe is macrocosm. M-A-C-R-O, macro means large. M-I-C-R-O, micro means small. In this macrocosm universe, there is the cosmic body. Huge body with earth, planets, galaxies, stars, sun, moon. It is the cosmic body. This body is this small body. What you find outside can be seen inside. You find earth outside, earth we have. We find fire outside, we have fire inside. You have air outside, we have air inside. We have water outside, we have fluids inside. We have sky outside, we have sky inside. This is microcosm, that is macrocosm. Outside you have the body, here we also have the body. And then the entire cosmic body is functioning with intelligence. We also have intelligence. The entire cosmic body has the cosmic prema, Vishwa prema. If the rivers are flowing towards the ocean, the rivers love the sea. If the fire is going up, fire loves the sky. Everywhere we can see the cosmic love. Similarly, in this body there is love. Cosmic body, individual body. Cosmic love, individual love. Cosmic intelligence, individual intelligence. Let us not discuss love here now. Let us not discuss body here now. We shall go to only intelligence. This intelligence, in the initial stages, in the beginning stages, is inertia. This desk does not have sensitivity. This does not have the vibrations. It is inert matter. This inert matter you find in us, nails. There is life, but there is no sensitivity. Hair, there is life, it grows, but you cut, it has no pain. Similarly, life is present everywhere, but pain is not present everywhere. When the pain is not felt, it is called inertia. It is tamas, and from that tamasic state to the total awareness we are rising, and that is our Devi Navaratri, conquest of the inertia. That inertia, laziness, is symbolized, is picturized, is presented, is shown in Mahisha Buffalo. Buffalo you touch, no sensitivity. You idiot, no response. You rogue, you are standing on the middle of the road, doesn't care. A sleeping person, you are sleeping. You are an excellent fellow, no response. You idiot, you are scoundrel sleeping, no response. Inertia has no response. And from that state, Amma, the Divine Mother, Cosmic Goddess, wakes us up. From that inert state, we come to impulses. Inertia lowest. Next stage is impulse. The trees have the sensitivity. There are certain plants, when you are trying to touch it, they shrink. Leaves shrink. They are afraid. When you take the axe, they are afraid. They love, they procreate, they rise, they grow. They have the attachment. If you play the song, if you play on flute, they respond and they grow better. Sufficient researches have taken place. Jagadish Chandra Bose has beautifully explained that the plant kingdom has the life and also the response. It is no more inert, it is impulses. From that impulsive state, we come to instincts. Impulses are there in us. For example, a boy is sleeping. I go there with a pin. I prick foot. He pulls the foot back. Next morning I asked, last night at 11 o'clock I came and I pricked your foot, do you remember? No, but you responded, you lifted it back, took it back. Impulses do take place without much of involvement. Impulse. From there, in the animal kingdom, you have the instincts. If a female dog is going, male dog runs behind. Instinct. If anybody calls me an idiot, I get angry. Instinct. When my neighbor is wearing a better, whiter shirt, I become jealous. Instinct. Instincts are animals. We have passed from the inertia through the impulses and to the instincts. Animal instincts we do have. A beautiful girl, a terrible person, we have the fears, we have the jealousies, we have the possessive greed. All these are instincts. From that level, we have become man or woman. Then it becomes intellect. For your remembrance, I say inertia, impulse, instinct, and then you come to intellect. Intellect is vichakshana jnana. Instinct says, a beautiful girl is going to look at that side, look at that, don't look. Intellect says, you feel like sleeping, don't sleep. Intellect says, you feel like fighting, no, it's not correct, he is stronger than you, you will be defeated, don't unnecessarily fight, control your tongue. Intellect says, intellect is a gift from God to man. Inertia, impulse, instinct, and we come to intellect. From that state of intellect, we go to intuition, awareness. This is the whole process. We have the inertia in us. We have the impulses with us. We have the instincts with us. We have the intellect with us. With the help of that intellect, we should become intuitive like a great sage Valmiki or Narada Maharshi or Yogi or Yoga Vasishtha Maharshi. That is the highest state, from sleep to a state of samadhi, from ignorance to enlightenment, from laziness to bright activity, we go on rising, and then there will be an aura behind it, and that is called tejas. That tejas you get when you are successful. Vijayadashami. Today is the second day. Second day we have to take the next step from tamas, from inertia. Let us rise higher. Let us go to a better place. And the best example is mother. Mother is never tamasic. Father may sleep, mother will not sleep when the child is crying. Mother is the best example. Prakriti Mata, never dull, never asleep. The earth is rotating, sun is shining, wind is blowing, rivers are flowing, and there is activity taking place. Time is running, action. Tamas is not present in Prakriti. It may appear to be a little dull, but it is always in action. Similarly, Mata, our own mother, my own mother, your own mother, she has that activity in three ways. Yesterday I said, wife may be tamasic, wife may sleep, girl may sleep, woman may sleep, mother does not sleep. Mother is always wakeful, mother is always careful, mother is always affectionate, and her three stages. Number one is Sparsha Diksha. Number two is Nayana Diksha. Number three is Smarana Diksha. When the baby is in the womb, the mother is in close contact with the baby. Physically, she nourishes the baby and she sacrifices everything. She is always conscious that the baby is inside. She is always aware that the baby is inside. If she takes ice cream, the baby may feel unwell. Therefore, she sacrifices. Mother is aware. Mother is careful. Prakriti Mata is like that. Constantly we are in physical contact with Prakriti Mata. I am on the earth. I have the breath. I am in the sky. I am with the water. All the five elements are constantly in contact with me. Prakriti Mata is fostering me. Prakriti Mata is bringing me up. Prakriti Mata is nourishing me. She is bringing me up. My own mother has brought me up in her womb. Sparsha. After the delivery, when the baby comes out, the baby is on the lap of the mother. The baby is on the chest of the mother. The baby, when it grows a little more, the baby is in the waist of the mother, constant contact. Sparsha. Without the mother's sparsha, no child can grow. There is no existence for the baby without the touch of the mother, inside and outside. First of all, inside. Father may not be in physical proximity with the child, mother is always. Prakriti Mata is always. And when the baby is able to crawl, when the baby is able to stand up, mother is no more in physical contact. Baby is on the floor. Mother will be looking at the baby. Wherever the child goes, the eyes. Nayana Diksha. So that the baby does not go to the fire. The baby does not go and catch an ant. The baby does not go to the road. Always mother is aware, conscious of the child. Inside it is Sparsha Diksha. Now it is outside Nayana Diksha. Similarly, a devotee constantly in contact with God, worshipping and always looking at God. That is the evolution. Mahishasura is being killed. Tamas is being killed by the mother. Mother does not sleep. She wakes up for the benefit of the baby. A devotee does not sleep. Always he lives with God. That prema is Divya prema, Daiva prema, Yogic prema. And now, when the baby is able to come up, study, and he gets married, he goes to America, he is settled there as a software engineer, he is with his wife. What does the mother do? Mother will be thinking of his son. Smarana Diksha. Constantly she will be thinking of the baby. Sparsha, touch, Nayana, looking at him. And finally, she will be remembering, thinking of the son. What will be my son doing at this time? He may be going to the office. All her prayers are for the benefit of the son's welfare. These are the three stages by which tamas is shattered, laziness is removed, inertia is buried fathoms deep, and mother loves and therefore intelligently serves, and mother is goddess. And that goddess is Mahishasura Mardhani. She has killed tamas for our benefit. And in Lalita Sahasranama, you have one beautiful word. Avyaja Karuna Murti. Murti is person. Karuna means compassion. Vyaja means cause. Avyaja means no cause, no karma. She loves because she is a mother. Why does a mother love the baby? Because the baby is the child of the mother. Karunamurti. There may be a bad son, but never a bad mother. There may be a lazy wife, but never a lazy mother. Mother is constantly aware of the baby's welfare. Vishwamata, Durga Devi, Lalita Parameshwari, Rajarajeshwari, Vishwamata is always showering her love on us through three ways. One is sparsha, by physical contact with Prakriti Mata, by always looking at her Meenakshi. Her eyes are open. She always looks at our welfare and rights. Kamakshi, always ready to fulfill our desires. Annapurni, always giving us food and fostering. These 9 days, we worship the mother. We try to imitate the mother. We try to rise to the state of that great cosmic mother by shattering that Mahishasura, by killing that Mahishasura. Let us in true spirit remember the great goddess, great mother, great our own mother, Matru Devo Bhava. And let us meditate on that Maa.